What's up, guys? It's Rantium here, and today we are back in Skyrim. That's right, you guys, and don't snap. It's gonna be an awesome freaking day. So, guys, welcome back, and happy Sunday. So, today we're back here in the wonderful lands of Skyrim, taking a look at this. Yes, this mod has a whole bunch of stuff inside of it that we gotta break down and look at today. But I did want to go ahead and let you guys know that today's mod showcase is probably gonna be the last mod showcase for a while, because I feel like I'm running out of things to showcase, and it's just kind of getting tedious at the moment. So, I think we're gonna probably start maybe a new series throughout the week. I'm just trying to work out my schedule and seeing, you know, what I want to do and stuff like that based on what you guys have told me and everything like that. So without further ado, let's check this out. So I saw this on Bethesda.net, and what's cool is all of the armors are indeed craftable, and holy crap, are there a lot of them. So we're going to take a look at all of them today, not to mention it comes with a whole bunch of weapons too. Now we'll take a look at those as well. But yes, keep in mind that all of these can indeed be crafted. So what am I currently wearing? Well, at the moment, I am wearing the Vigilant of Stendar Hauberk with the Vigilant of Stendar Topfelm. And then we've also got ourselves the Chainmail Bracers and the Chainmail Boots. Now what this mod does is it adds a whole bunch of factions, armors, and weapons that you would normally not be able to wear or use within Skyrim because, well, it's different parts of the world. So take, for instance, you know, the Alakir. The Alakir, really the only thing that we can wear of them is like the Redguard stuff. But now we have the helmets that they would probably wear, you know, like a ceremonial helmet or something like that. You know, we've got the noble armors and everything like that, the noble helmets. They look kind of crazy on your person, don't get me wrong, but it is pretty cool. And then, you know, we've got the shields that are, you know, accustomed to the heritage and the culture. And then we got, you know, the Alakir turban and stuff like that. But then we've got this one. This one's kind of an interesting one. Keep in mind, it also comes with light armor and heavy armor variants of most, if not all, of the armors, which is kind of a nice touch for those that want the same armor, but maybe don't want to use heavy armor. So let's take a look at the Bloodhorker's heavy armor. So I just disappeared for some reason, but that's okay. So the Bloodhorker's heavy boots, heavy gauntlets, and the heavy helmet. So the Bloodhorker armor just looks really, really cool. Kind of gives me a Hannibal Lecter feel with that little grate over my mouth, and kind of an Iron Maiden feel, I'm not going to lie. But it just reminds me of what I would see in, I don't know, maybe a Viking show or something like that. Like, if you took the helmet off, this is pretty Viking, if I'm going to be honest. But I love the little mittens that your hands have. The gauntlets, it should just be called Iron Mittens, because that's exactly what they are. But I know it's because, you know, the Horkers, they live up north, and it's just kind of really cold, so you don't want your fingers to get frozen. But overall, still kind of a nice little, kind of a nice looking armor. But there are, you know, subtle texture changes when you change from the light to the heavy. This is obviously the light because it's made out of more leather rather than, you know, the hard and sturdy iron and steel reinforcement on the face. And then, you know, you can take a look at the Bloodhorker's light armor. Doesn't really change a whole lot other than, you know, maybe a couple little things. But there is indeed a medium armor version, but it's still just heavy armor. There's only 1 point lower in the armor value as far as what you get for your bang for your buck. But let's take a look, let's take a little bit of a different direction now, and let's take a look at the Alakir armor. So there's, like I said, light armor and heavy armor, but we're going to take a look at the light armor and see what we got right there, and then we'll take a look at the heavy one here in 1 second. So then, let's see, what kind of helmets, there's only a heavy helmet, or is there, what's the noble helmet, is that a, no, okay, so it looks like there's only heavy helmets, but that's okay. So here you go, the Desert Warrior. Super cool way to look at yourself. Just a neat outfit, honestly. You know, it's got the baggy pants to get a little bit more airflow in there. But then you've got that nice little, you know, pattern on your chest to keep you protected from slashes and arrows and stuff like that. Very nice stitching on the back. And I gotta say, that's one of the things that I love the most about this mod is the fidelity, the graphical fidelity of every piece, every weapon, every armor piece. Everything is high quality. And it's really, really nice, and it really shows in the way that everything looks. And of course, you've got the really cool chainmail across your entire face. Would probably get a little bit warm, if I'm honest, but it is still pretty cool. Although I can't get over the fact that I just look like one of those, what the hell are they called? The chows? No, not chows. I look like a turnip, or like a beet, or something like that. You know, some sort of vegetable. but it's kind of funny. But let's take a look at the heavy armor real quick, and we can do that. Let's see, heavy gauntlets. We've got the heavy armor right there, and then the heavy boots, and then the heavy helmet. So it doesn't change all too much. It just adds a little bit more metal, a little bit more chainmail, and changes the color of the pants, which is really cool to see. The boots, they've got those little curved tips at the end, which is kind of funny looking. And you'll notice that I have an assortment of weapons attached to me. That's because I'm using the mod What's it called? Visible Favorited Gear. That's a wonderful mod, I swear by it, because it allows you to show off a whole bunch of the weapons that you have here in Skyrim. It's pretty cool. So now that we've seen kind of the Alakir one right there, let's take a look at what the Noble Armor looks like. So the Noble Armor is a little bit more ornate, obviously, because it is a noble. It takes away the chainmail from the front and leaves it on the sides, right and left side. And then it has kind of a really spirally turnip on the top of your head. Kind of cool. And then obviously the pants are quite ornate. A little bit gaudy for me, if I'm honest, but still, nonetheless, kind of cool. So as we move through the armors, we've seen the Alakir, we've seen the Bloodhorker, and we've seen the Vigilant of Stendar, but we're going to take a look at those ones again, because there are different variants as to what you can use. So you've got the Bloodhorker shield right here too, I meant to go over that too. So the chainmail boots and bracers are more so there for you to mix and match with a couple of other things, especially when we get down to these. So the Halden armor, the Halden bracers, the Halden helmet, and the Halden boots. This is... I don't even know what the hell I would call this. Maybe a mixture between the Alakir and, you know, I don't know. It's like a mixture between the Alakir and the Vigilant of Stendar armor that we saw in the beginning of the mod showcase. But it's just a really cool looking armor. Reminds me a lot of, like, just... It looks like it's been inspired by maybe like a samurai chest plate, you know, with like everything that comes down towards where the torso and the waist meet. It's just kind of a neat looking armor, honestly. And like I said before, very high quality, really, really cool textures on there. But then let's go ahead and take a look at the, those were the Hauberk boots. So maybe we could actually take the chainmail boots and that would match a little bit better. Either that or we could take and put on the plate boots. Yeah, that's probably what those ones are for, the plate boots, yeah. But then let's go ahead and come all the way back up here, and let's take a look at the Hauberk. Now, I don't exactly know, because I'm not privy, you know, to medieval societies and everything like that, so I don't exactly know if these are based off of historical, you know, non-fiction, historical accuracy, but a lot of them look like they could be. You know, the chainmail and the irons and the, you know, the leathers and stuff like that. It's really kind of cool to be able to see this in Skyrim. But let's see. Halden armor, we don't want that. But is there, like, an iron hand? Let's see. That's kind of cool. Look at that. Holy crap. Talk about a freaking juggernaut. Holy crap. That is just so cool looking. Not to mention, it just looks classical. And that's really, really nice. The attention to detail is wonderful in this mod. But then we go ahead and get into some of this stuff. So we do indeed have the iron hand helmet and the iron hand armor. And you can use the plate boots, and then you can have on, you know, maybe some chainmail gauntlets or something like that. But then, now we can get into the Knight of Stendar. Now, the Knight of Stendar is different from the Vigilant of Stendar, because this could possibly be seen more so as the Crusader-type person, you know, that's going to worship Stendar, but at the same time, cut down some motherfuckers who are in his way. Not that a Vigilant of Stendar wouldn't do the same thing, but this just says a little bit more about this person. Just super cool accents on the armor. You know, you've got the really cool the stamp right there with the ribbon hanging down really nice. The helmet looks dope. I love that so much. Just a really cool thing. But honestly, every single one of these armors I look at and I just see the meme where it says, like, parry this, you fucking casual, and it's a knight carrying a gun. That's what I see with this armor. Just somebody who is not fucking around. Just someone who doesn't give a shit what you have to say. He's gonna beat the ever-loving shit out of you. And then you've got the Paladin of Stendar armor, which is just a little bit more ornate. If you want to become a paladin rather than a knight, you know, you have your chainmail dress on and your nice fabrics and, you know, your big epaulets and pauldrons and everything like that. Really, really cool. Nicely done texture work. And like I said before, super high resolution. Look at how close I am to that chainmail, and it hasn't broken up, which is really nice. It's a nice touch. But then we start to get into the really cool ones. So we have the Silver Hand Heavy Armor. So the Silver Hand, obviously, are the werewolf hunters here in the lovely lands of Skyrim. And you can really tell that this was probably based on maybe some of the old knights. some of the old knight armors and stuff like that, as were most of these, I assume. But it's just a really cool mixture. We could probably go ahead and use the chainmail bracers and the chainmail boots, if I had to guess. Let's see, was there... no. Okay, so there weren't any ones that were with the silver hand, but those match perfectly. Look at that, almost as if they were made for the silver hand armor. Just such a cool thing. And then we've got, you know, you have the heavy armor, and you've got the light armor, or kind of the medium armor version. And then the silver hand shield just looks crazy dangerous. It's like the targe of the blooded just got worse. And then last but not least, we do indeed have a couple more of these outfits down here. These ones, I think, have to be my favorite. The Topfelm and the Vigilant of Stendar ones right here. So you've got light armor and heavy armor. Not a whole lot of difference other than just the shoulder pauldrons and stuff like that. And then the classic wooden shield. Just super cool. Super simple. Nothing crazy. But let's go ahead and throw on my Knight of Stendar. Knight of Stendar there. Paladin of Stendar. Knight gauntlets and knight boots. Perfect. So go ahead and showcase the weapons. So the weapons, there are an assorted mix of weapons here in this mod. And we're not going to really take a look at them on the ground as much. We'll probably take a look at a couple of them. But we've got the Bastard Battle Axe, which I imagine is just supposed to be a battle axe, because a bastard is normally just left for the sword that you can use in one hand or two hand. You've got the Bastard Matic, which is kind of like an axe. It's a two-handed battle axe. You've got the Morning Star, which is... it's so cool. It's so badass to see a Morning Star in Skyrim. You've got the Trench Club, which is a really, really cool take on a type of, like, a flail or morning star. But it's just so... it's so brute. It's really cool. So you got the Bloodhorker's Axe right there. Really cool look. I think that one's two-handed. No, that one's one-handed. Oh, this one's the two-handed. The Bloodhorker's Battle Axe. Really cool. The Bloodhorker's Sword. Very blunt-looking, almost. But, not as refined as, you know, like a knight's armor or a knight's weapon. Then you've got the Iron Hand Greatsword, which I'm just a huge sucker for. It's just a big-ass claymore that you can sit on the back. Just look at that. It's beautiful. Look at how far out those freaking tongs come out from the hilt. Super cool look. And then we've got the Keeper Carset Mace. Now keep in mind, some of this, or most of this, in fact, all of it I crafted, including the enchanted ones. So the enchanted ones you can indeed find in the forge. And you can craft these at any forge, which is really nice. And then we've got the Knight of Stendar Mace, and you know, you can take a look at the enchantments and stuff like that. Then you've got the Paladin Warhammer. This thing is just, it speaks for itself. Look at it, it's so crazy looking. But then you get into the really cool one, the Silver Hand Crossbow. It's just a stake of wood with a little bit of metal, a little bit of iron, and you've got the crossbow to just end a freaking vampire's day. Then you got the Silver Hand Greatsword, which this thing just looks insane. Holy crap, I didn't even take a look at this before I showcased the mod. Look at that. It's freaking serrated to shit. Oh my god, that is terrifying looking. And then you got the Silver Hand Sword, which is just a scaled down version of the Great Sword. And then you have a scimitar, which I want to say scimitar was spelled incorrectly, but what a beautiful weapon. Holy shit, it looks elven. Just absolutely gorgeous, and it's a two-handed one. So if you're looking to roleplay as like a Juggernaut Alakir soldier, you know, a Red Guard soldier with a little bit of oomph, that might be the weapon for you. And then we've got the Tolan Warhammer, and last but not least, the Vigilant of Stendar Mace. Now, keep in mind, there may be a few things there in the crafting section where you can, you know, see a couple of other things, but this is the majority of the things that you can craft here in this mod. And I gotta say, as far as bang for your buck goes with both armors and weapons, not to mention you've got, you know, historical accuracy, I have to assume, and just a total badass look, the mod is worth it. You know, I use... Private Eye's Heavy Armory with this mod as well, so you can have a trident if you wanted, you can have a short staff, a quarter staff, you know, stuff like that. It really gives you the option to make the armors and the person that you really want. So, let me know down there in the comment section, guys, would you use this mod? I'm curious to see what you guys would say. And did you like it? Did you hate it? Let me know down there in the comment section, and let's have a little talk about it. I know a lot of people didn't like the last showcase from the day before, but, you know, I guess to each their own. But With that being said, thank you everybody so much for all the support that has been shown through the past 2 years of doing mod showcases. It's been crazy. Whether or not they'll come back in the future, I can't tell. But I think I need a break from mod showcases. So expect something new, not necessarily Skyrim. We'll still be doing the Let's Play during the week as far as, you know, the live streams go. But don't expect Skyrim on the weekends. Perhaps just, you know, stick around and see what happens. If not, it's been nice knowing you, and it's been nice having you here. So with that being said, you guys, thank you so much for coming on by, and I will see you in the next video.